Should you start marketing yourself before you're ready, or should you wait until you have a product and then start marketing? That's the question for today, and I have an answer for you because honestly, this is the chicken before the egg conundrum. What should you do first? And I'm gonna give you 5 ways to know if you are ready, and then how to actually get started no matter what you decide. But one of the things that I wanted to really focus in on with this question is there are 2 schools of thought. One is start before you're ready. That's the kind of girl I am. And 2 is wait until you have things buttoned up and then start. If you are new to my channel, my name is Ashley Tate and you're watching The Social Life, the place where I share strategies and tactics to help you increase your profit, share your purpose, and build in more productivity to your life while you manage it all so you can design a life and business on purpose. So now that we've got that all taken care of, I want to jump into the 5 things that you need to ask yourself before you start marketing so you can know if you're actually ready as a new business to get yourself out there and start marketing. For many of you, you're looking at this from the perspective of, I want to get my name out there. I want to show people what I'm doing. I want to share what I'm doing, but I don't know if this is the right time and I'm not sure if I'm completely ready in order to start pushing myself out there and I don't have things in place. And this is completely normal. Like I said earlier, this is the chicken before the egg conundrum. Which way does it actually work, right? So here are 5 things I want you to think about before you get started. Number 1 is think about your ultimate goal. When it comes to your marketing, are you trying to just increase awareness or are you trying to create a profit? Which one are you trying to do? And that's important to understand because that is your overall ultimate goal for your marketing efforts. And it's important to have an objective for your marketing planning, your marketing strategy, all of those things. It will make things so much easier. Number 2, is your product actually available? If someone wanted to support you, is your product available? Can they purchase it today? Do you have the delivery system in order? Are you ready to give that product to someone, or are you asking people to sign up on a waiting list for when the product comes out? And either of those answers are perfectly fine. It just depends on what you're trying to do and where you're at. So I just want you to kind of make a note of some of these things. Number 3, understand the marketing tools that are available for you to share your product. Do you understand the marketing tools that you plan on using? If the answer is no, we just might want to evaluate that a little bit further before you start actually marketing. Number 4, now this is a big one, and a lot of people do not take the time to actually figure this out, and you guys hear me say it all the time. Know your customer. The deal is, if you don't know who you're talking to, you really are going to miss the person that really wants to be a part of your mission or a part of your business or use your product because you're not speaking in their language and you're missing what they really want and see as value and as a benefit. So ensure that when you are thinking about this, about marketing, do you actually know who you want to speak to and who your customer is? Number 5, is the foundational work complete? Now, when I talk about the foundational work, I mean, do you have your bank account open? Do you have your QuickBooks in order? Like, are you ready to actually start the business? And I don't mean marketing the business. I mean starting the business, like the basic foundations of starting the business. Now, if you answered no to any of these questions, then you are probably not at the point that you need to start marketing. But if you answered yes to all of these questions, then let's move on to the next piece of the puzzle. Now, even if you answered no to some of these questions and you're ready to start marketing, you feel like, hey, look, I'm so excited about this and I want to get it out there, then you are just more focused on awareness rather than profit. And that is okay. Now, one of the things I want to say on this is to meet your business where it is. Okay, so sometimes we have businesses that are like, hey, I have a product, I'm ready to start selling, and you can go start creating a selling strategy, and that's fantastic. That's also one of the things that we talk about in the Unleash Your Profit course. We talk about how to set up your launch, how to set up your strategy for selling, how to create a profit for your purpose or your business or whatever it is that you have, and walking you through that whole process. how to create a marketing plan, all of those things. So if you're there and you'd like a little help on that directly, you can come join us in the Unleash Your Profit course, where I meet with you weekly to go through group coaching as you go through the coursework and really get your business set up and on the right path to start building a profit. And these five tips that I'm going to share with you guys today are going to walk you through the five things that you should be doing, whether you're starting out for a profitable strategy or you're starting out for an awareness strategy. So I'm going to give you five action items to do before launching your new business. Number one, start an email marketing system for your business. That is number one, because you want to be able to reach out to your audience, give them a call to action, and then continue reaching out to them at your will. As opposed to waiting for an algorithm to show your content, you are now able to actually put your information out there as often as you'd like. What this does is develop a relationship over time with your audience, and that's an amazing strategy. Now, the next strategy I'm going to talk to you about in the next video is all about how to build a relationship through your email marketing system. So stay tuned for that as well in our next video. Number two, I want you to take the time to write down your target customer. This is so important and it cannot be overlooked. It is something that's going to guide just about everything you do in your business. And I will leave that worksheet down in the description below, but it is incredibly important. I can't even explain to you how important this is to make sure that you have this locked in. Your target customer is the key to building a business, growing your audience, growing your profit. All of those things are understanding who your target audience is. Okay, I'll get off my soapbox now. Number three is to understand your personal goal. Now, all of us have lots of different goals for business, and some of us want to be millionaires. Some of us just want to provide for our family. Some of us just want to have something extra to do and something that we love. And those are all okay. But your personal ultimate goal will dictate the decisions you make as they come up and as they arise, the decisions that you'll have to make for your business, the decisions you'll have to make for any future employees, the decisions you'll have to make on your time, all of those things will result in the ultimate goal mindset that you have when it comes to your business. So really think about, what is my ultimate goal? Why am I actually starting this business? What does it mean to me? What is my overarching vision for this idea that I have, right? Because we want to make sure that we're always going in the right direction towards what's most important for us, as opposed to what business should look like for everyone else. Okay, so it's really important to keep in mind. Number four, I want you to create a growth schedule. Now, what this means is, over time we have things that we need to learn. Now, when I talk about creating a growth schedule, I will talk about this in a future video, but the short idea behind it is that you want to create a schedule where every Thursday, maybe that's how I do mine, every Thursday I use that time to really delve deeper into something that I don't know about my business that could really catapult my energy, my productivity, my profit, anything that will really help grow the business. And it's just something that I don't know that I need to spend a little bit more time on, but maybe I don't have that time during the week or during other days. So I have a growth schedule and I write down what I'm going to use on those days. Number five, before you get started marketing your business, you need to know how you best express yourself. How do you feel that you are best as far as time-wise, the amount of effort you want to give, and your natural set point in how you communicate for yourself? Is it speaking? Is it writing? Is it just audio? Because these are ways that you're going to be expressing yourself and finding your audience. These could be things like, I enjoy speaking on camera. Okay, well then you might be great for YouTube. I enjoy just doing audio, but I don't want to be seen. Then you might be best on a podcast. And if you're a writer, then that's probably one of the best things that you could be in this day and age, because blogging, writing your newsletters, all of those things are going to require you to write. So find your best mode of communication and use that in order to build your audience and know how you're going to start this marketing plan. So in this series, I've already talked about the number one tool that is going to help you build and grow your business consistently. And also, I've talked to you about If you're ready to start marketing, here are 5 action items that you should do before you actually get started. And in my next video, I'm going to talk to you about a strategy that you can use when you're using that number one marketing tool and really any other place that you are talking to your audience. I'll be talking about that in the next video. So thank you guys so much for being here today. That's all I have for you. I want you to get out there and unleash your something amazing. And I will see you next week. Thank you again for being here. Bye, guys.